Are they breathing?
No, ma'am. My wife and my son.
And what is your name?
My name is Alec Murdaugh. Please hurry. Neither one of them's moving.
A prominent lawyer. An unfathomable tragedy. Allegations of deceit.
He's a very caring person, and she was the rock of their family.
Do you think they will find who did this?
I would certainly hope so.
Tonight, we'll break down the timeline of events, from the decades of power to the multiple investigations.
And so it makes you wonder, okay, is this alleged shooting connected in some way to the death of his son and his wife?
From the beginning to the most recent developments.
Obviously, everything is up for question now.
Including two deaths now being revisited by state investigators. And what's next for Alec Murdaugh?
This is the kind of story that really has no good ending.
Murdaugh, Death and Deceit, starts now.
The mystery into the Murdaugh family has a tangled web of characters and events. For the next 30 minutes, we will unpack it all. Good evening. I'm Riley Miller. Over the last few months, the stories have only become more complex. But where do you begin? For this, we go back decades.
For almost a century, a member of the Murdaugh family held the title of 14th Circuit Solicitor, covering five counties: Allendale, Beaufort, Colleton, Hampton, and Jasper.
The function of a solicitor in South Carolina is the same as the function of a people's attorney or a prosecuting attorney or a district attorney in other states, and that is to prosecute criminal cases.
As soon as the position of solicitor became an elected one in 1920, Hampton attorney Randolph Murdaugh Sr. was chosen for the job. He was killed in a train wreck in 1940 and was succeeded by his son Randolph Buster Murdaugh, who held the position until his retirement in 1986. Buster's son Randolph Murdaugh III was then elected and served until 2005.
His influence was not limited to this circuit. As solicitors in South Carolina are political animals, they necessarily have political bonds that they maintain. And I think that used to be a lot more important when Buster was coming up than it is now.
But the influence of the family extended beyond the role of solicitor. The family's powerful law firm, today known as PMPED, has been in operation for more than a century.
That law firm has some really, really fine lawyers who just happen to be very, very skillful.
PMPED accused Alec Murdaugh, Randolph III's son, of stealing money from the firm at the beginning of September. Alec resigned, but his brother, Randolph Murdaugh IV, is still listed on the firm's website, despite the tragedies that have recently surrounded the family and put the Murdaugh name in the national spotlight. McCloskey believes the PMPED law firm's prominence will survive.
You bet. Those guys are good at what they do, and they're going to remain prominent. Is it something that they're going to have to find ways to quietly overcome? You bet. This is not fun for anybody. This is the kind of story that really has no good ending.
As we dive deeper and deeper with every twist and turn, it circles back to the big tragedy that sparked all of this: the killing of Maggie and Paul Murdaugh. It was June 7th when investigators say they were gunned down in Hampton County. The case still unsolved tonight. Here's Dale Julin.
I need the police to pass this immediately. My wife and child just got badly.
Is he moving at all, your son? I know you said that she was shot, but what about your son?
Nobody's. They're not. Neither one of them's moving.
He's sobbing. He's shouting into the phone. He's begging the dispatcher to send officers and paramedics.
Okay, and what is your name?
My name is Alec Murdaugh.
Okay, did you hear anything, or did you come home and find them?
No, ma'am. I've been gone. I just came back.
Okay, and was anyone else supposed to be at your house?
No, ma'am.
As both ambulances and squad cars race to the scene, the dispatcher sticks to her training, keeping him on the phone, knowing she needs his help so the officers can find the scene fast.
Okay, can you do me a favor, Mr. Murdaugh, and turn on the flashers on your car so that way they can see where the kennels are?
21.
Do you have your flashers on for me, Mr. Murdaugh?
Yes.
I don't want you to touch them at all, okay? I don't know if you've already touched them, but I don't want you to touch them just in case they can get any kind of evidence, okay?
I already touched them trying to get to see if they were breathing.
They were not. Knowing he could no longer help them, he asked the dispatcher for permission to do what he never thought he'd have to do.
Ma'am, I'm going to call. I need to call some of my family.
Okay.
In the months that have followed the double murders, authorities have not publicly released the names of any suspects. Murdaugh himself remains a person of interest. Dale Julin, WJCL 22 News.
As Dale pointed out, authorities have not named any suspects. In fact, late this week, South Carolina State Police say because of the ongoing investigation into the double murder, agents, quote, uncovered other potential crimes that warrant further investigation. They also said the FBI and the United States Attorney's Office are involved. But what other crimes are we talking about? Perhaps the failed suicide fraud plot that put Alec Murdaugh behind bars. Shannon Royster picks up the story from there.
The botched shooting of South Carolina attorney Alec Murdaugh is quickly unraveling around him and playing out like a Hollywood movie. Back on September 4th, Murdaugh was shot in the head on Salcahatchie Road in Hampton County, months after he discovered the bodies of his wife Maggie and son Paul, shot to death outside their home back in June.
Are they breathing?
No, ma'am. My wife and my son.
And what is your name?
My name is Alec Murdaugh. Please hurry. Get the one up and moving.
The next time Murdaugh called 911 was for his own emergency. A family spokesperson said Murdaugh pulled off to change a tire when a man in a blue pickup truck stopped to see if he was having car trouble. They say instead of helping, Murdaugh was shot. The attorney was airlifted to a hospital in Savannah. Police calling his gunshot wound superficial with no visible injuries. However, Murdaugh's lawyer said the police report was incorrect, saying he had a skull fracture and entry and exit wounds. 2 days later, on September 6, Alec Murdaugh was released from the hospital and issued a statement saying he regretted decisions he made. He was resigning from his law firm and entering rehab for substance abuse. That same day, his former law firm issued a statement of its own, saying Alec was stealing money from them. His law license was suspended immediately by the South Carolina Supreme Court, and SLED opened an investigation into those claims. At this point, legal expert Susan Williams says it's turning into a complicated case.
How it went from Alec Murdaugh being shot in the head to rehab to suspension to resigning, that is a whole lot.
Spring forward to September 14th. Curtis Smith is arrested and charged in connection with the Alec Murdaugh roadside shooting.
Curtis, you have anything to say?
The very next day, news spread of a scheme. Authorities saying Murdaugh admitted to an assisted suicide plan with Smith, who happened to be a former client. Police say Murdaugh gave Smith a gun to kill him so a surviving son, Buster, could collect a $10 million insurance policy. Problem is, it didn't play out that way. Murdaugh survived and is now facing big trouble. Attorneys representing Alec Murdaugh say he's battled opioid addiction for years and needs help. But first, Murdaugh agreed to turn himself in, appearing in a Hampton County court on September 16th. His lawyers driving home the point of dependency.
This is a 20-year addiction. This is something he's struggling with every day. And if anyone wants to see the face of what opioid addiction does, you're looking at it.
Murdaugh is facing charges of insurance fraud, conspiracy to commit insurance fraud, and filing a false police report. His bond set at $20,000.
Murdaugh has returned to an out-of-state rehab center. He could face up to 20 years in prison for his role in the assisted suicide insurance fraud plot. The mystery surrounding the Murdaughs brought national attention to what's typically a quiet and rural community in the Lowcountry. It also caught the attention of ABC News.
Abrams, our chief legal analyst, joins us now. And Dan, we heard Alec Murdaugh. He released an interesting statement mentioning decisions he regrets. What could he be alluding to?
Well, look, this sort of shifts the focus a little bit. Up to this point, I think a lot of people were looking at the son in particular. Remember, he was shot along with his mother. He had a pending criminal trial. He had a pending civil trial. There were questions about whether he was involved in a 2015 case. And so there were a lot of questions about, was he targeted? But now the dad comes forward and announces that he regrets decisions that he made, and he's going to go into rehab. And so it makes you wonder, okay, is this alleged shooting that happened this weekend connected in some way to the death of his son and his wife? And that's something we just don't know the answer to at this point.
And this is someone who came from a long line of prominent attorneys in that community. And now the allegations of that he took money from his law firm, where could that lead?
I think that's going to lead to this unraveling. I mean, I think for the first time there's something concrete here, which is saying there was an issue, there was a problem. And I think it's going to lead us down the road to at the very least understanding what happened with his alleged shooting. We'll see if that's connected again to the death of the son and the mother.
This is so bizarre.
It is so bizarre. And it's been months since the murder of his wife and his son. And no arrests have been made.
Yeah.
Where do you think that case is?
And that becomes the question, right? Question A is, is that connected to dad? If it's connected to dad, I think we're going to see this solved quickly. If it's not connected to dad in any way, we may be back at point one again. But remember, when the son and the wife were shot, the police came out and said to the community, you don't need to worry. Clearly, they knew that this was a targeted shooting. They were telling people in the community, you don't need to be concerned, et cetera. So that right there tells you they knew something about it, at least enough to be convinced that this wasn't some random killing.
You said bizarre.
Yeah.
And Eva and I were just sitting here talking about it back and forth, right before we went on. And both of us were asking each other questions. Well, what do you think? What would happen? Because there are so many questions involved still.
Yeah. And no answers.
Yep.
No concrete answers.
Yeah,
Dan, thank you.
Layers of investigation. All right, thank you so much.
He's a very caring person. And she was the rock of their family.
In the days after Paul and Maggie were found dead, other members of the Murdaugh family came forward. Murdaugh, death and deceit continues. Brothers of the Murdaughs spoke out just days after their two relatives, Paul and Maggie, were found dead.
I got a call from Alec Monday night. And as soon as I answered the phone, I knew something was wrong. Oh, man. He just told me. He said, come as fast as you can. Paul and Maggie have been hurt.
His voice. The fear. He was just distraught. But the person that did this is out there. And there's information, however big or however small it is.
Did they have any enemies?
I really don't know of any enemies. You hear all this talk on the, social media with regard to Paul, but I don't know of anybody that would truly be an enemy. I truly want to harm them.
Paul had been awaiting trial, accused of being under the influence while crashing a boat that killed 19-year-old passenger Mallory Beach in 2019. He pleaded not guilty in the case. Emma Hamilton now with what happened that night.
I never knew what it would be like to go through something like this.
911, where's your emergency? Police, fire, ambulance. Hello?
February 24th, 2019, the night that put the Murdaughs back in the spotlight and changed the Beach family's life forever.
Please send someone.
No, I'm coming. We're coming, okay?
Investigators say Paul Murdaugh was driving a boat under the influence with five other teenagers, including Beach, when he crashed into a bridge near Paris Island.
Five of us are on the bank, but we're missing one person.
It's going way too fast.
I don't even know. I finally got to the point I grabbed my girlfriend and put her in my lap in the bottom of the boat and was holding on with my eyes closed. The next thing I know, I'm in the water.
Beach was gone.
Bro, you smiling like you're 40.
Sit down.
My girlfriend gone, bro.
Sit down.
You think it's funny.
Police say Paul was, quote, grossly intoxicated, yet he wasn't issued a field sobriety test, nor did he ever spend a night in jail.
Y'all know Alec Murdaugh.
Oh, yeah, I know
his
name.
That's his son.
That's so grabbing.
Good luck.
Authorities, search teams, friends, and family searched for an entire week. Until...
911, where's your emergency?
We think we found her.
Beach's body was found on March 3rd, 2019, in a marsh near the Broad River boat landing. Later that month, her family filed a wrongful death lawsuit against Alec and Buster Murdaugh, plus Parker's convenience store, who sold Paul the alcohol the night of the crash. April 18th, 2019 would have been Beach's 20th birthday.
It is hard. Yes, it's hard. There's moments that we have that things remind us of Mallory, and we break down at times.
It was also the day that Paul was indicted for boating under the influence, causing death, and two counts of boating under the influence, causing great bodily injury. Paul pleaded not guilty to all charges. The court-ordered mediation in the wrongful death lawsuit failed on June 4th, 2021, meaning the case would then head to trial. 3 days later, Paul and his mother, Maggie, are found shot to death at their family's hunting lodge.
Obviously, everything is up for question now.
The Murdaugh's maid's mysterious fatal fall, considered an accident at the time, but now a new investigation. Murdaugh, death and deceit continues.
When it comes to weather forecasts, you've told us one thing matters, for us to get it right. And only one Savannah weather team is certified most accurate. Who keeps track? It's called WeatherAid. Analysts who compare all forecasts to what actually happened. We got it right more than anyone. Storms, temperatures, wind, and sunshine. Every forecast, every day, analyzed for the last 3 years. Jeremy, Jonathan, Victoria, and Melissa. The Storm Tracker 22 weather team. Certified most accurate.
Our families, our close friends, the people we surround ourselves with are always there when we need them. When the unthinkable happens due to accidents or sickness, Compassion Funeral Service will be there for you. Compassion Funeral Service will help guide you through your toughest time. Every family is unique. Compassion Funeral Service takes pride in working hard to meet all your requests and traditions. Sometimes the unexpected happens. When it does, Compassion Funeral Service is here.
iCults, we're different because our focus is very community-oriented and very team-focused. When meeting with someone who's been injured on the job, you have to realize that often this has changed their life. I tell my staff, my paralegals all the time, we're dealing with people at some of the lowest points of their life, some of the roughest times they go through. So being able to help them with that is one of the greatest joys, I would say, of practicing law.
The Hedges, since 1929, a symbol of resilience and pride, fed by the passionate fidelity of Bulldog Nation, and some say, watered with the tears of their opponents. This Georgia tradition presented by your local Ford dealer, where you'll find America's best-selling trucks. Just announced, get 0% financing for 72 months on a 2021 Ford F-150.
Go Dogs.
Is your credit score getting in the way of the things you want to do? Personal loans through NetCredit offer fast and flexible lending. Borrow up to $10,000 and choose repayment terms that work for you. You may even be able to build your credit history as you repay. NetCredit, a more personal loan.
Trust, built day by day, story after story.
Good evening, and it's great to have you with us.
It strengthens with understanding.
Learning what's important to you.
what you need to know right now.
WJCL 22 News and ABC World News Tonight with David Muir.
A focused look at local and national news.
The news that matters to you in Southeast Georgia and the Lowcountry.
It's a matter of trust.
We begin tonight with breaking news.
WJCL 22 News and ABC World News Tonight.
A criminal investigation into the death of Gloria Satterfield is now open, as well as the handling of her estate. Satterfield was the Murdaugh family housekeeper for more than 20 years, who died in a mysterious trip and fall accident inside the Murdaugh's home. All this as Satterfield's sons file a wrongful death lawsuit. We sat down with their attorneys for a breakdown.
Obviously, everything is up for question now.
Attorney for the Satterfield family, Ronnie Richter, says Gloria Satterfield, the Murdaugh family's housekeeper for more than two decades, was practically family to them.
For her boys, when their mom passed away, it was very natural that they would have entrusted such important matters to Alex, who assured them that he was going to, quote, take care of them.
The newly filed lawsuit states Alec Murdaugh approached Satterfield's sons, saying he would help them get compensation for their mother's wrongful death by filing claims against himself. But Richter says there's a big red flag in this case.
The person getting sued picked the lawyer who's going to sue them, and not coincidentally, that lawyer happened to be a close personal colleague.
In 2018, Alec Murdaugh's insurance company paid more than $505,000 in a settlement. But according to their attorneys, Satterfield's sons didn't find out about this until they read it in the newspaper 3 years later. And there's another major problem for her sons.
And they've not received the first dime.
Attorney Eric Bland, who's representing Satterfield's estate, believes there's more to all of this. And that's why this lawsuit was recently filed in hopes of getting more questions answered.
We believe that there wasn't just $500,000 that was recovered in connection with the death of Gloria Satterfield. We believe that number is much greater and in the millions of dollars.
A letter from the Hampton County coroner states Satterfield's death was not reported to the coroner at the time, nor was an autopsy performed. It also says the manner of death on Satterfield's death certificate was ruled natural, which is inconsistent with a trip and fall accident. The housekeeper's death is not the only one to receive fresh scrutiny. In June, SLED announced they opened an investigation into the death of Stephen Smith, a young man found dead on a road about 10 miles from the Murdaugh home. Ashley Garrett now with what we know.
Oh my gosh, we've been waiting on this forever.
Sandy Smith wakes up every morning thinking about her son Stephen and her search for answers since his death in 2015.
And they said he was shot in the head. And then it turned out it was a hit and run, and then he was beat up, and so the story just kept changing.
Stephen's body was found along Sandy Run Road in Hampton County in July of 2015. According to the coroner's report at the time, his death was likely due to a hit and run.
I just couldn't believe it, but when they told me hit and run, I said that's impossible, because Stephen wouldn't have been walking in the road to start with. He would have cut through the woods. He would not have been in the highway.
Now, 6 years later, with no arrest made, that search for answers continues. In June, the South Carolina Law Enforcement Division announced that they were reopening the investigation into Stephen's death. In a statement then, they said the decision to look into the death was based on information gathered during the murder investigation into the deaths of Paul and Mackie Murdaugh, but they didn't detail what that information was. This week, investigators confirmed to WJCL 22 News that the new investigation is ongoing, but that they have no additional information. For Sandy Smith, it could be another step closer to justice or more unanswered questions.
It's like he's a nobody because we're poor people.
Ashley Garrett, WJCL 22 News.
Murdaugh, death and deceit continues. Over the last 30 minutes, we walked you through the complex history and developments with the Murdaugh family. It's a tangled web of secrets, tragedy, and mystery. We thank you for watching our special program, Murdaugh, Death and Deceit. The conversation, though, does not end here. We continue it online at WJCL.com, where we have extensive coverage, including a timeline of everything you just saw and more. You don't have to go far. It's right on the homepage for you. Good night.